There's two kinds of stressors. You got the kind of stressors that are negative stressors, things you're missing, and they're the kind of stressors that are positive stressors, things you're doing to your body. Emotional stressors and psychological stressors clearly are important, but there's also physical stressors. Sugar is a big, major stressor. Processed food, major stressor. Fats, processed fats, trans fats, major stressors, because we're talking about a fat problem. And if you start putting in trans fatty acids, hydrogenated fats, margarine fats, cinnamon bun fats, processed food fats, you're just adding to the burden. See what I'm saying here, folks, is I don't want to be Mr. Health guy here, but the point is that our bodies are getting carved up by the medical model. We're getting drugged and we're getting poisoned and nothing's helping. And these are things that we can do ourselves. Simply by reducing your intake of processed foods, reducing your intake of refined carbohydrates and sugars, reducing your intake of fructose, which is a major, major health burden on the liver, especially high fructose corn syrup products, and using the Mighty 90 essential nutrients, getting on the Healthy Start Pack, getting on Biolumin Nightly Essence, using fermented foods, these are all things we can do ourselves. We can save our money, we can save our bodies, and we can really be getting to the core of the problem. All right, on our next Bright Side episode, we are going to continue talking about SIBO, and we're going to talk about the link between mental health and small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, especially when it comes to a disease or a health condition that is now becoming an epidemic. One out of 15,000 people suffered from this particular condition back when I was in pharmacy school. Now it's one out of 68. It's gone from one out of 15,000 to one out of 68 in 30 years or so, and it is a big, big problem, and there's a major link between it and small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, and this is an issue that affects our children, and we'll talk about this on Monday on our next Bright Side episode. Okay, 855-660-4261 is our number. Let's go to Texas and welcome Kyle to the Bright Side. Good morning, Kyle. What's up, bro? Hello, Kyle. Kyle? Hey,
yeah,
Kyle.
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. What's up?
I'm calling about high blood pressure.
Okay, simple. Easy peasy. You want to lower your blood? Is it for you? You sound like a youngster.
Yes. I am.
Young.
I'm 44.
And you got high blood pressure? Got hypertension?
Well, they're saying that maybe I need to start taking some medicine for it.
Oh, really? That's what they're saying?
Yeah.
Do you know that high blood pressure drugs are among the deadliest and nastiest and most toxic drugs of all? And that's saying something because there's a lot of deadly, nasty, toxic drugs. If you have high blood pressure, first of all, high blood pressure is a classic sign of a stress response. That means you got to figure out what's causing the stress. Like I was just saying, there's negative stressors and there's positive stressors. But here's the thing about these high blood pressure drugs, okay? If you have your circulatory system, right, and you got vessels that are spread out throughout the body, right, and blood is getting out to all the extremities from your head to your toes and to your fingertips, all throughout the extremities, correct? You follow what I'm saying?
Right. Yeah.
High blood pressure is a manifestation of the blood vessels at the extremities closing up, and somehow the blood is not being pushed out far enough, and the pressure is building up. So what they'll do is to give you a high blood – does that make sense how I explain that? The extremities, the blood vessels are closing, so the pressure is starting to build up in the center of the body. So what the brain-dead medical model will do is they'll shut down your circulatory system. They'll shut down the pressure. They'll slow down the heart. They'll literally poison your heart. Now, who came up with this idea? They'll usually give you a diuretic first, and that poisons your kidneys. It poisons your kidneys, so it changes how fluids are handled. But then they'll give you a beta blocker drug or a calcium channel blocker drug, which literally poisons the heart. Now, who thinks this is a good idea to poison the heart? Ask your doctor about that when he tells you, oh, we're going to put you on this nice little beta blocker drug or calcium channel blocker drug. Ask him, doc, isn't that going to poison my heart? See what he says, and then say, Doc, is that a good idea, really? Don't I need my heart? Isn't that important? Did you ask him that?
I did say that. Yeah, he said that, it's minimal side effects.
Oh, it's a minimal poison. It's just a little poison. Okay. I don't want
to
beat him.
Let's do it naturally.
Well, let's do it naturally. Here's number one what you want to do. Deep breathing. Oxygenation. Make sure you're getting oxygen into the bloodstream by practicing deep breathing techniques. That's step number one for hypertension. Step number two is nutritional supplements that help the entire body, but especially that help the circulatory system. And most importantly, the B vitamins, especially niacin. All the B vitamins are extremely important for blood pressure issues, and you'll get those in the Beyond Tangy Tangerine. You might want to throw in a little bit of extra niacin. 100 milligrams or 200 milligrams of timed-release niacin. That's the best way to get your niacin. That's the second thing you want to do. So first, you want to deep breathe. Secondly, you want to do the B vitamins. The third is magnesium. Magnesium is a superstar, it's a superstar mineral for everything, but it's a superstar mineral for the circulatory system. It will relax the blood vessels very, very effectively. Get on the Osteomag. You also probably want to get a little calcium, so make sure you're using the entire Mighty 90, the Healthy Star Pack in general. Then you want to focus on digestive health, especially when it comes to sugar. If you're not processing sugar correctly and your insulin is whacked out and you're starting to get into elevated insulin problems, that's going to affect your blood pressure. Insulin problems and blood sugar problems and hypertension also go hand in hand. So focus on sugar intake. Number one, reducing sugar intake. Eating more protein is the best way to do that. And then also using nutrients that help you metabolize sugar. Chromium and vanadium, the sweeties, can be very helpful for hypertension issues and for blood sugar issues as well. So you got lots of options here, and then a few other miscellaneous ones. Omega-3 fatty acids are also important for hypertension. And most of us get way too much omega-6s compared to omega-3s. You'll get your omega-6s and your omega-3s from the Ultimate Essential Fatty Acids. These are all wonderful strategies for lowering blood pressure. Last but most certainly not least, focus on any foods that cause digestive distress. When your body goes into any kind of stress response, including digestive distress, your blood pressure is going to go up. So if you have food allergies, food intolerances, link them up to link your digestive problems to specific foods and eliminate those foods. Okay?
One quick thing. I also have IBS, and I've basically gone macrobiotic.
Well, hang tight. I'll talk about that. That's what I was just saying. Digestive problems cause general stress, and that'll cause hypertension. IBS is absolutely linked to hypertension. Hang tight, Kyle. And if you're on hold, hang there. Hang on. We'll get to you when we come back from our break. I'm Pharmacist Ben. You're listening to The Bright Side. 855-660-4261 is our number. We'll be back after this.
If you suffer seasonal or environmental allergies and your doctor has told you that the only answer is medications for the rest of your life, Dr. Peter Glidden has an alternative solution that doesn't involve drugs with terrible side effects.
One of my favorite add-on products to the 90 essential nutrients for people who are suffering with allergies is a product called Cell Shield RTQ. Cell Shield RTQ. The Q in that product stands for a biochemical called quercetin, and quercetin is a natural antihistamine that doesn't flag out your immune system like antihistamines do.
To manage your allergies without a lifetime of prescription or over-the-counter drugs, order Youngevity's Cell Shield RTQ today by calling 855-347-3696. That's 855-347-3696 or on the web at fireyourmdnow.com. That's fireyourmdnow.com.
So we decided to upgrade the look of our home.
You know, improve the curb appeal.
We decided to add the look of stone to the exterior.
We really like the stacked stone look.
Yeah, but when I checked into the price, it was ridiculous. No way could we afford it.
Then a friend told me about Genstone. G-E-N-S-T-O-N-E.
Genstone comes in lightweight panels made of polyurethane. They've actually engineered the hassle out of installation. No mortar, no mesh. It was easy. Even I could do it.
We just screwed the panels to the wall and it looks like stone. I mean, it really looks like stone.
Yeah, from the box to the wall in minutes.
We love the look of our home now.
And Genstone is durable, comes with a 25-year warranty, and offers additional R-value for insulation.
If you want the look of stone at a price you can afford, call Genstone.
At 855-955-STONE. Trust me, you'll save money.
And you'll love the look.
855-955-STONE. That's 855-955-7866.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional and installation. You control what you watch when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels, too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
Today is an important day. It's your day to be ready, take care of your family, and buy your emergency food supply from the Freeze Dry Guy. Because today, the Freeze Dry Guy introduces our Mountain House and Packaway one-month food supply. Today, get the Freeze Dry Guy's 30-day premium unit, normally $364, sale price at $263, save $101. Buy two cases, normally $727, sale price at $506, save $222. Or choose three 30-day premium units, normally $1,091, now only $748, save $343. From the Freeze Dry Guy. These premium units are packed with the highest quality Mountain House entrees, meats, vegetables, and Packaway brand freeze dried pineapple and dehydrates, such as milk, ABC stew, and rolled oats. 289 half cup servings. Go to freezedryguy.com or call 866-404-3663. That's freezedryguy.com or call 866-404-3663. Free shipping to lower 48. Hurry, our Mountain House and Packaway 1 month supply sale ends soon. So call now, 866-404-3663.
UnseenNow.com, proud sponsor of GCN. Unseen Now's unparalleled encryption tools keep your communications secure. GCN.
All right, we're back on the Bright Side talking to Kyle in Texas. We got Kyle. Hey there, bro.
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, so last thing you said was IBS, irritable bowel syndrome, and then you said the macrobiotic diet, right? You're on the macro.
Well, basically, I don't want to take too much time from anything, but I've been just trying everything. Like, I meditate. I've been really strict with the diet. And
how's the IBS? Is it working?
Well, I'm barely getting that stuff to budge is all, and that's why I'm just getting frustrated. Like, what do I do?
Don't get frustrated. The macrobiotic diet. The macrobiotic diet, as I understand, is a grain diet, grain and veggies. Is that what you're talking about?
Basically, yeah. I mean,
that's not good, bro. That's going to mess you up. That's going to mess up the bowel thing.
Okay.
Stay off of the grains. Grains and bowel problems they go hand in hand. You got to stay off the grains, and the macrobiotic diet is also you don't get any butter or any animal products, so you're not going to get your vitamin A, which is very important for the bowels. You don't have a hypertension problem. You got a bowel problem. And it's causing the hypertension. You follow? Don't even worry about the hypertension until you get the bowel problem straightened out. If your dumb doctor, excuse me, I shouldn't say that. If your doctor told you he's going to put you on a blood pressure drug and he hasn't fixed your irritable bowel syndrome, you need another doctor. You should do this yourself. Focus on foods, and I'm going to let you go after this, Kyle, because I got some other calls I want to get to. You need to get this bowel thing under control by focusing on the foods that are causing the problem. Write down every single morsel you put in your mouth, every single food you put in your mouth, and then write down in the notebook how you feel digestive-wise or how your bowel movements are, gas, bloating, fatigue, headaches, anything after you eat that food, okay? And do it every two hours or so. So you eat a food, write it down in the book, and then 2 hours later, how you feel. 4 hours later, how you feel. 6 hours later, how you feel. 8 hours later, how you feel. All the way up to 10 hours, and you keep a running total, a running tab of the foods, and you link them all up to how you feel. You follow me? Is this making sense, Kyle? Kyle? Okay, well, we lost Kyle. So if you're listening, Kyle, you want to write down everything you eat. Are you there? I don't know what's going on.
Yeah, I'm here. I said thank you very much.
Okay. Okay, good. Did that make sense?
Yes, it does. Thank you.
Okay, good. And then get on the Biolumin Nightly Essence as soon as possible. It's very important that you start to restore the gut bacteria. With IBS, you probably have a big problem with your gut bacteria, and that can cause all kinds of issues.
Okay.
So you treat your hypertension and all your other symptoms as a digestive problem, as an IBS issue. Thanks so much for your call, Kyle. I appreciate that. How can a doctor do that? How can a medical professional talk about drugs to a guy who has IBS without addressing the bowel issues? Ugh, for the life of me, I cannot figure out what is going through these medical professionals' minds. Sandy in Wisconsin, welcome to the Bright Side. What's up?
Thank you. You often talk about magnesium, but you never specify
the type?
What kind of a magnesium. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. First of all, the best way to get...
I am taking magnesium primarily for migraines, which has helped me immensely.
Good deal.
Wanted to find out from you and all your wisdom what type.
Okay. Well, there's definitely various types of magnesium. So your question is definitely appropriate. Magnesium is best... the best way to get magnesium, let's be clear right now, is in foods. And the best way to get everything is in foods. The problem is we don't know where the foods are grown, the plants are grown, and so we don't know.